Ramaphosa, that is an English grammar. It's my first video on YouTube channel Grammar Sikhu. Today I would like to say something about. I want to give you some highlights on English grammar. So as we know, English grammar, it consists of the English language. When we speak of grammar, it will mainly focus on the English language. So today I'm going to give you some knowledge about the English grammar. That means what are the speech, when we talk, when we are using conversational things like writing things, what is very much important is our communication skill. That may be writing or even oral form. So in both the form, so for that purpose, grammar is very important. Grammar is very important in English literature. In any language, grammar is a base of the language. So when we talk about English grammar, then speech, when we are talking, like I'm talking orally, verbally, this is what literally when I'm speaking, it's like one form of grammar, that is a oral grammar. So while writing in English, in English language, what we are trying to do today is the base of the grammar. The base of the grammar, that is the base of the language. So first, in my class I'll show you the part of speech. When we are talking or we are writing, there are eight main parts of speech. Okay, eight main parts of speech in English. Parts of speech. Okay, so speech is the, when we are talking orally, speech comes in that form. Okay, that is in English grammar. So number one is noun. So now, what is noun? Noun? In the lower classes, we have already studied that noun is the name of a person, place, animal, or thing. Okay? So, it's a name. Naming words are what we can consider as naming words. That means naming words, right? For example, Ram, Lucknow, Delhi. Okay? Now this is what? These are nouns. Now, when we talk about noun is also being classified under many types, like proper noun. What is proper noun? Proper noun is a proper name of a person, like Ram. It's what comes under proper noun. Now, diversion in noun, that is proper noun, proper name. And proper noun, number two is the common noun. Now what do you mean by common noun over here? Now common noun is what? Noun can be classified into common noun, proper noun, abstract noun. Okay? Now these are the different types of noun. Now second comes the noun pronoun. Now what do you mean by pronoun? Pronoun is the word which is used instead of the noun. Like when we talk, we cannot repeat the word again and again. Like for example, he, she, they, etc. These are all what? Pronoun. These are the word used instead of a noun. Number three is adjective. Adjective is a word which describes a noun or a pronoun. For example, long, black. Now these are what? The words which describes a noun or a pronoun. Now these words are known as what? Adjectives. Number four, adverbs. Adverbs. Now what do you mean by adverbs? Adverbs are the words which add something to the meaning of the verb. Like what? what? Like example, quickly, etc. Number 5 is verb. Now what do we mean by verb? Action words are known as verb. Action words like running, swimming, jumping. Running, swimming. It shows, the verb which shows some actions like running, swimming, eating, walking, jumping. These all are what? Verbs. And now, pronoun, adjective, adverb, verbs. Conjunctions. Number 6 is what? Conjunctions. Now, what do you mean by conjunction? Conjunction is a word which joins a sentence or a clause. Okay? Like, for example, if I say, Rama went to the market to get some fruits. Now what is the conjunction over there? Two will be what? Conjunctions. Number 7 will be what? Preposition. Preposition. Now what do you mean by preposition? Preposition is a word which is used to describe place of manner, place of the noun, pronoun or a subject. For example, like the cat was sleeping beneath the tree. That means which will be the preposition over there? Beneath will be the preposition over there. B-E-N-E-A-T-S, beneath. Okay? Number 8 is what? Introduction. What do you mean by introduction? Introduction is a word which is used conjunction joining preposition. Introductions are what? Exclamatory. Okay, now these are the common part of speech used in English language. That is the noun, pronoun, adjective, adverbs, verbs, conjunction, preposition and introduction. Thanking you. Let's meet in the next class.